Hello friends, welcome to a new lecture on surgery, which is lipoma. So lipoma, it is a benign tumor. It can occur anywhere. Mainly it is a benign tumor and it arises from yellow fat and it is a benign tumor. So if the benign tumor arises from yellow fat, it is called as lipoma. If it arises from the brown fat, it is called as hibernoma. Okay, this lipoma, it can occur anywhere in the body, anywhere, the whole body. It can occur anywhere from the body, starting from the head to whole body. But there is one area where lipoma can never develop, that is brain. That is important. Lipoma can never ever develop in brain. So brain is an area which is spared. Okay, so lipoma can never develop in brain. Okay, it can occur anywhere in the body. Now, this lipoma, it can be diffuse or localized. If it is diffuse lipoma, sometimes it is not capsulated. The diffuse lipoma, which is not capsulated, this can occur in palm, soles, neck. The lipoma, which is diffuse, it occurs in palm, sole and neck. This is for diffuse lipoma. Okay, sometimes lipoma can be multiple or single. Now, the lipoma, it can be associated with other tissues. Whenever the lipoma, it is associated with fibrous tissue, fibrous component, it is called as fibrolipoma. If the lipoma is pedunculated, then that is called as pedunculated lipoma. That is like this. If the lipoma is pedunculated, it is called as lipoma arborescens. There is a special type of disease which is really important, which is called as Derkham's disease. So in Derkham's disease, the patient has fat deposition, that is lipoma, that is tender fat deposition on the trunk. So on the trunk, there is tender fat deposition on the trunk. Okay, on the trunk, there is tender fat deposition. This tender fat deposition on the trunk is called as adiposis dolorosa. Okay, which is adiposis dolorosa. Sometimes this lipoma in the thighs, sometimes the lipoma in the thighs or in the shoulders or in the back, this can turn itself into sarcoma. Okay, in the thighs, in the back, in the shoulder, it can turn itself into sarcoma. So there are many sites where the lipoma can occur. If this is the skin, this is the subcutaneous tissue, here there will be the muscle. Okay, there is one more muscle. Okay, this is the layer, and there can be a tube, there can be serosa, muscle and mucosa, muscle again mucosa. So lipoma can occur anywhere in the body. It can occur subcutaneously, it can occur subfacial below the fascias, it can occur intramuscular, it can occur intermuscular, it can occur subserosal, it can occur submucosal. Sometimes it can even occur between the joints. So it can be intra-articular or it can be subsynovial also. So these are the different sites where lipoma can occur. So it can be subcutaneous, subfacial, intramuscular, intermuscular. It can be subserosal, submucosal. It can be intra-articular. It can even be periosteal, or it can also be subsynovial. So these are the different sites where lipoma can be. Lipoma can be present anywhere in the body, at any site of the body, at any depth, except in brain. So what are the clinical features? The clinical features is lipoma, it is localized. It does not cause any systemic swelling. It is sometimes it can be lobular. Okay? So it can be lobular, and then it is non-tender. Okay, it is semi-fluctuant because fat in our body is in semi-liquid position, And as a result, it can be semi-fluctuant, not completely fluctuant, but it can be semi-fluctuant. The skin is pinchable because lipoma will never occur in skin. It occurs below the skin. As a result, the skin of the lipoma is always pinchable. What are the differential? Sometimes it can be pedunculated. The main important thing is slip sign is positive. What is slip sign? It just slips under the skin like a mouse. Like a mouse, it just slips under the skin. So if you just palpate the one side of lipoma, it slips to the other side. It goes to the other side. So that is the reason slip sign is always positive in the lipoma. So how are you going to treat the lipoma? The treatment of lipoma is excision. If it's small lipoma and if it is only subcutaneous, you can give local anesthesia. If it is larger lipoma and if it is subserosal or submucosal or in other areas, then you will have to give general anesthesia. So what are the complications of lipoma? As I have said, it can transform itself into sarcoma, or sometimes it can undergo myxomatous change. Sometimes it may undergo saponification. Sometimes it may itself undergo calcification. Sometimes if it is a submucosal lipoma, this can cause intussusception and thus intestinal obstruction. So these are the different complications of lipoma. I think you have got some idea about lipoma. So thank you guys for watching my lecture. If you have any doubt, please comment it in the comment section. Thank you for watching my lecture. Thank you.